Hi all, Abe here. Welcome back to the chat. Here's hoping you and yours are doing well. Today we're continuing our playthrough of No Man's Sky's Permadeath mode. In our last episode, we met up with Null, another traveler that has been watching us throughout our adventures across the galaxy. And he seems to have a way to save Artemis via a device called a Mind Arc. We are then tasked to craft this device, and now we are out, gathering the necessary materials for its construction. And that's where we left it. Let's pop in. Let's see what we can get into. Alright, so we gotta go and find ourselves some materials to make this Mind Arc. Okay. Might as well get that going. No, I should probably get my other ship. Let's go ahead and call in the big dog. Let's get that bad boy here. And the first traveler is what we're looking at. I have encountered another traveler named Null. They seem unusually aware of my journey and have offered a way to save Artemis. They claim it is possible to restore Artemis's mind and store it in a device they called a Mind Arc. Alright, so we need to mine some cadmium, construct the Mind Arc, gather components, and the galaxy map, search for a red star. Alright. Report the appearance of Null to Nada. We'll do that in a little while. Let's go ahead and get this cadmium we need. I don't know. Let's just go. Let's see what's up. Imihito system. Or I am Jito. I me Jito. Yeah, that's it. I me Jito. All right, let's take a look at this planet over here. See what we got. All right, so I landed on this redacted planet. Flaming hail is the weather.
Flaming
hail. All
right,
so there's an armored clam over there that I'm gonna need.
Oh Lord.
And there's a cadmium deposit right over there. All right, let's go ahead and. Oh, there's one right here too. Let's bang this bad boy out. Alright, so I think that is plenty cadmium for our needs. Let's get back on the ship. Alright, so I need the first traveler. Mine cadmium. I just mined the cadmium. Why is it still telling me to search the map? Not make this thing? Okay, so I still need glass and soul engine. And soul engine needs the pearl and the plating. So the living pearl comes from clams. And I'm pretty sure we saw an armored clam not too far away. Let's go ahead and check that bad boy out. What? Where is it? Huh. Must be underground, I guess. Oh, there it is. Alright, let's get in there. Oh, crap. Oh my gosh, did I just destroy the clam? I can destroy the clam. You know, let me get out of here. Let's see if there's another planet we can go ahead and get this done. Wow, there's a couple of planets here. We should... Let me go and investigate. It's a little small sidetrack. Object of interest detected. Oh. Wow. This is a messed up freighter. Cool. Any cargo pods? I don't see any cargo pods that I could... Oh, for the love of Christ, these freaking guys. So I decided to go around and explore this entire solar system. Got myself a couple of these storm crystals. Checked out this mushroom planet. That's beautiful, by the way. Landed on this other planet that had a couple of these metal fingers. And mined all the gold off of them. Oh. This one is a black and white planet, apparently. A crimson planet. Fevered clouds. Oh, well, that's nice. Right? So, perfect spot. I'm done exploring this place. Let's get back to business here. And I want to check out this high-tech Corvex place. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. Oh. Aminaya something. Yeah, another space battle. Awesome. I'm not interested. Let me head over to the space station real quick. Wait, that's a traveler. Hey, buddy. How you doing? I approach the lost traveler. Their skin is translucent, as if they were not truly there. No kidding? That's never happened to me before. We were born too late to make a difference. Well, that's terrible. And as we have done in the past, after a brief conversation, I was able to secure the location of the traveler's grave. Before I headed out, though, I did want to upgrade my starship with that augmentation that I got previously. And I went ahead and got myself another slot. Alright, that completed. Let's head over to the grave. I left the fallen traveler in peace and secured myself yet another glyph. That's 7 out of 16 glyphs at this point. Alright, there's one more planet on this. There's two more planets that I need to go check out since I'm here. Nothing much of interest here. Let's continue on. And in searching the remaining planets of the solar system, I came across another one of these manufacturing facilities and secured myself another recipe. At this point, I went on this random kick of going to yet another star system that serves really no purpose. Just wanted to go, so off I went. Let's go ahead and take a look at this planet. At the Karach system. Karach? No, Kariach? Kariach? Who knows? Oh. We got ourselves a nice little marble planet. Pick one of these things up. Take it to the house. Oh, this looks like a nice water planet. Very nice. Oh, look at this. Beautiful. Purple trees. Water, grass. Very nice. Oh wow, look at this. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and I think I'm gonna make a base here. So I might as well probably get a portal from here. So let's go ahead and do that. Kamchayan, ice, Guking, Viking, something, something. I feel a strange chill. A layer of frozen gas suddenly coats the monolith from top to bottom. It's so cold that I can see my breath inside my helmet. There is one small gap in the crystal ice, and I feel convinced that I could feed some of my mind elements through it, so they can come into contact with the monolith behind. Let's insert some condensed carbon. The frozen gas melts into the atmosphere, and I am rewarded. You have learned the Atlas word for infinite. Nice. Alright, standing with the Viking has increased. Let's go ahead and talk to this thing again. The ancients that inhabit this monolith accept my presence. They will tolerate a request. I request that you give me the location of a portal. Sweet. Alright, so, nice planet. Spoke to a monolith. Got a location to a portal. I think it's time we hunker down and got a base. Oh, well, let's take a look at the portal. Oh, wow, look at... Nice. in this little ditch here. Very cool. The portal. Alright, so let's do our usual and put a marker up so we know how to get here. And I don't need to use this right now. Hey, look at this bad boy over here. What is this? Oh, the big kitty. The big kitty. While searching for a suitable site for a base, came across another manufacturing facility and secured myself another recipe. Planet's kind of weird. Oh, for the day everything's like reddish, and at night it's green. It's another drop pod. All right, let's get in here. Let's repair this thing, and let's get ourselves another slot. All right, what do we got here? Oh, drop pod number two. While searching for a new site for a base, came across not one, but two drop pods, and secured an additional two slots for my exosuit. Yeah, beautiful planet. Ooh, red water. Very nice. All right, so we want to set up near the water somewhere. Oh, and here's another one of these manufacturing facilities. Got myself another recipe. And another manufacturing facility. And another recipe. Man, at this rate, I'm going to just get all this stuff. All right, so I'm trying to find a nice place. And I kind of like this spot right here. Got access to some clams. Yep, like the spot. I think I'm going to make the base right here. Let's go ahead and drop down the base computer. And let's claim ourselves the base. Cool. Now let's get on the hunt for some power. So I came across this issue while looking for some power near the base. And as I'm running towards the spot, it disappears. It just disappears. If I move back just a few feet, it reappears. And what the hell's going on with that? 145 units to get to the spot. Clearly the direction is this direction, and it disappears the minute I just go through this imaginary line somewhere. I don't understand what's happening. I spent way too much time trying to figure this out, and I just couldn't. I went back, I went forward, I went around to try to see if there was some sort of, I don't know, some kind of structure that was impeding my ability to get to the hotspot. In the end, I just gave up. Now, I did find another location. There's the base computer at 715 units. And I found a power spot 688 units from my location, which makes it way too far. And I have no choice but to move the base to around this area where I'm at now. And considering I have some armor clans and some other stuff nearby, I figured I might as well just make a base here on the beach. Alright, now that we settle on the spot, let's build the base. That might be straight, I don't know. And to the magic of editing, we're just gonna zip right through all of this.
Okay,
and there it is. Simple base with a pier. Access to get into the deeper part of the water there. It works. I should probably stop goofing around and get this thing done. Alright, so let's get back on task here. And why is it saying to mine the cadmium? I mine the cadmium. I don't get what... why it's telling me to have to mine the cadmium. And even after moving around some inventory, nothing happens. Alright, so now we have some more metal plating. Alright, so I got the soul engine made. Does that make a difference? No, it's still telling me to construct the mine arc by gathering the components Oh, wait a minute. Gather the map, search. Let me go to the galaxy map real quick. All right, so it wants me to gather this from a specific place. That's the problem. So let's warp there. My jump range was not sufficient, so I had to make a smaller jump. But you know what? Since I'm here, you know, man, you can't put me into a place where the, wow, look at this planet. Beautiful. Oh, this is a beautiful planet. Look at this. Bountiful planet, weather, lethal humidity, outbreaks. Okay. It turns out there was a specific planet we needed to go to, and after a few jumps to get to that location. We have arrived. I honestly don't know what possessed me to jump towards the core when the mission was right next to me. No idea. But such is the way things are in No Man's Sky. You randomly decide, you know what? You don't want to do a mission right now. You want to go and explore, and you just take off. It happens. What can you do? All right, so Yantor is where we were originally, as I recall. And look at this planet. There's some cadmium right there. All right, so now that we've landed, it says to collect some more cadmium, so that's what we're going to do. Mind you, I collected all this cadmium before, but I already constructed the device. All right, so now it has accepted that I have mined the cadmium, and is telling me to get the living pearl, which, of course, you guys know I already did. Cadmium, we've got to take one of these lights with us, get it back to the house. But I'm sure it's sending me to another location specifically to get that. All right, so harvest the pearl. All right, so I have to go to this specific... It appears I have to go to this specific planet to, or this system rather, to get the pearl. So let's just go there. Don't do as I do, people. Oh, another space battle. No, thank you. All right, so that looks like that's a water planet. Let's get there. Object of interest detected. What do we got? Oh, got ourselves a traitor. Moose Corvax Quacka something. The traitor transmits their cargo manifest, revealing a strange collection. Their hold is full of relics. Okay, so let's bargain for a relic. 850,000 units. No, I'm not giving you 850,000 units for that thing. I'll give you a Corvax Convergence, though. Lustrous weaponry. Okay, I guess we will find out if that was a smart move or not at some point. But, okay, here we are at the water planet that we were supposed to go to oh, so many moons ago. We need to harvest a living pearl specifically from this planet. Okay. Let's do that. Rainy planet. Weather. Blistering floods. Sentinels. Hateful. Wow. Man, the sentinels are hateful and we get blistering floods. Whew. It does not look nice here. Look at this. I'm already starting to cook. Alright, let's get into the water. Let's get our living pearl. Nice. Now it says craft metal plating. Wow, it's making me go through this whole thing. I hope it doesn't make me create the soul engine again, but I guess we will see. Alright, so create some metal plating. What is wrong? Oh no. This sentinel is being a jackass. Dude, relax. Relax. Oh, okay. Fine. If you want to die, then I should be happy to oblige. Look at the dodge. I'm dodging you. Okay. Alright. Let's get out of here before his big brother shows up. That's never fun. Alright, so we have the pearl. It says, return to the mission agent. What? No. Let's go back to the first traveler. What does it tell me now? Craft a soul engine. Okay, craft metal plating. So it needs me to create the metal plating, even though I have the soul engine in stock. Okay, fine. And of course I need some more ferrite dust. Ah! Okay. Let's go. Let's go ahead. Let's just go back to the base and I'll craft the metal plates there. All right. Blissful, observant. See? Paradise planet, blissful and observant. Who wouldn't want to live here? All right, so metal plating. All right, so we got all the metal plating. It says construct a soul engine, and we... Okay, it accepted the soul engine we already constructed. So that's good. So it looks like, we need what? Refined glass? Okay, so let's make some glass.
Okay.
And now that we have the glass, let's create the mind arc. Awesome. Alright. Assembly of the mind arc is complete. Okay, all that running around, albeit primarily due because of my innate need to explore every planet I see. But still, finally completed the mind arc, and we have a waypoint to go to. So let's go ahead and check it out. Holo terminus activated. Multiple signal sources available. The tower hosts a powerful transmitter designed to facilitate holographic communication across long distances. Alright, let's tune into Artemis. Signal match detected. Alright. Use the mind arc. Oh! I activate the mind arc. I do not know what to expect. Some show of light and fury. Some catharsis, where Artemis emerges in the flesh, restored to life before my eyes. But it's not to be. One moment I see their hologram, and the next, there's nothing. The stranger who gave me these blueprints beckons me over. Their signal still active. Null, you turd. That didn't work. Alright, speak to Null.
Travelers are a dream. An idea that we have some special place in this universe. Artemis had it. You had it. Apollo too, though they would conceal it. Even I had this dream long ago. We are countless, my friend. Walking these worlds, yearning for friendship. No one wants to be alone. Not truly. But the closer you get to others, the more you risk hurting yourself, hurting them. The deepest secret of the universe is not that of the glass, or the Aerons, or the progenitors. It is that final act, the decision to abandon those who need you. It is the primal sin, the foundation of existence itself. Go to the stars, traveler. Your friends wait for you. They will help you bring peace to poor Artemis. Return when you are finished. We have much to discuss.
Okay. Seek help for Artemis. I thought that's what I was doing, but okay. Well, looks like I'm gonna leave that there for now, folks. Thank you all very much for watching. My name's Abe. Catch you on the next one. Bye for now. Thank you.